In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, More Properties of Exponents, also known as Properties of Exponents, Hard. Now in this section, we're going to simplify, and our answer should only contain positive exponents. So looking at number 1, let's start by combining what's inside of the parentheses. So using our product rule, it'll be x to the negative 2 plus negative 3, and then that raised to the 4th. So we'll have x to the negative 5, since negative 2 plus negative 3 is negative 5, and that will be raised to the 4th. Now we'll use our power rule. So we'll have x to the negative 5th times 4. Continuing our work, x to the negative 5th times 4 will be x to the negative 20th. So because our answers need to contain only positive exponents, we're going to have to make this a fraction. So x to the negative 20th is equivalent to 1 over x to the positive 20th. So using the negative exponent rule, we put x to the positive exponent in the denominator. So 1 over x to the 20th is our solution in number 1. In number 2, since my x's are not together within the parentheses, I'll have to distribute this exponent of negative 3 at the start. So I'll have x to the 4 times negative 3 times 2x to the 4th. So x to the 4 times negative 3 is x to the negative 12, and I'm going to multiply that by x to the 4th, and I cannot forget that whole number 2. So that will be multiplied by 2, and I can rearrange that because multiplication is commutative. So x to the negative 12 times x to the 4th will be x to the negative 12 plus 4, using our product rule, and that will get multiplied to 2. X to the negative 12 plus 4 will be x to the negative 8, and that will be multiplied by 2. However, we cannot have a negative exponent, so I'll have to make that into a fraction. So I'll have 1 over x to the positive 8 times 2, which is equivalent to 2 over x to the 8. And that's our solution in number 2. In number 3, I'll start by distributing my exponent of 3. So I'll have n to the 3 times 3 times n to the negative 1, and all that will also be multiplied by 2. So I'll have 2 times n to the 3 times 3, 3 times 3 is 9, so 2 times n to the 9th times n to the negative 1. Now I'm going to be adding 9 to negative 1 as my exponents for my base of n. So I'll have 2 times n to the 9 plus negative 1, or simply 9 minus 1. So that would be 2 times n to the 8th, since 9 minus 1 is 8. And number 4, I have 2v, and that quantity squared times 2v squared. So I'm going to need to distribute this squared to the 2 and to the v. So I'll have 2 squared times v squared times 2 times v squared. 2 squared is 4, so I'll have 4 times 2, and then I'll combine my v squared and v squared to be v to the 2 plus 2. 4 times 2 is 8, and that 8 will get multiplied by v to the 4th, since 2 plus 2 is 4. So 8v to the 4th is my solution in number 4. So number 4 is a great example where 2v, that quantity squared, is very different than what it's multiplied by, which is 2v squared. Continuing on to number 5, I'm going to simplify at the start. So I have 3 in the denominator, and I also have 3 in the numerator. Both of those, 3 divided by 3, will cancel out to equal 1. So now, I'll combine my like terms. 2 will get multiplied to 4, so I'll have 8, and then I'll have x squared times x squared. So I've taken care of the 2 and the 4, then x squared and x squared. That will also get multiplied to x, and then I have y to the 4th times y to the 4th. So now I've taken care of everything within my numerator, so I just need to work on my denominator. And that's just x to the negative 3 times y squared. So now when I rewrite this, I'll have 8 times x to the 2 plus 2 plus 1, since this x value has an exponent of 1, So I can combine those to be 2 plus 2 plus 1 as the exponent since they're multiplied together. And that will be multiplied by y to the 4 plus 4. And that's all over x to the negative 3 times y squared. So I'll have 8 times x to the 2 plus 2 plus 1 is x to the 5th times y to the 4 plus 4, which is y to the 8th. And that's all over x to the negative 3rd times y squared. Now I'm going to be using my quotient rule, which says when terms with the same base are divided, their exponents will be subtracted. So I'll have 8 times x to the 5th minus negative 3 times y to the 8th minus 2. So it'll be 8 times x to the 5 minus negative 3 is 5 plus 3, so that's 8x to the 8th times y to the 8 minus 2, which is y to the 6th. So my final solution is 8x to the 8th times y to the 6th. And number 6, let's simplify. At the start, 3 divided by 3 is 1. So now I'll rewrite this as 2 times y to the 3rd times y to the 3rd. So taking care of my y to the 3rd and y to the 3rd. And I've already written down my 2. So I still have my x, so I'll multiply that by x. Now looking at the denominator, I have x squared and y to the 4th. So now I'll simplify. So I'll have 2y to the 3 plus 3 times x all over x squared times y to the 4th. So that is equal to 2 times y to the 6th times x all over x squared times y to the 4th. So I'll rearrange this so that I can subtract my exponents from the denominator. So I'll have 2 times y to the 6th minus 4, since I have y to the 6th divided by y to the 4th, and that will be multiplied by x to the 1 minus 2, since I have x divided by x squared. So that would be 2y squared, since 6 minus 4 is 2, times x to the negative 1. Now because this x has a negative exponent, it's going to go in the denominator. So I'll have 2y squared all over x to the 1, or simply x. 2y squared over x is my solution in number 6. In number 7, I'll combine x to the 3rd and x to the 3rd, so I'll have x to the 3 plus 3 times y to the 3rd all over 4x squared. So that will be x to the 6th times y to the 3rd all over 4x squared. However, I still have terms where my bases are the same, so I'm going to simplify even further by writing this as x to the 6 minus 2, so subtracting my exponent of 2 because it's in the denominator, multiplying that by y cubed, and that will be all over 4. X to the 6 minus 2 is x to the 4th, and we're multiplying that by y to the 3rd, and that's all over a positive 4. X to the 4th times y cubed divided by 4. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 8. If you haven't done so already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. So now that you've hopefully done that, let's go over number 8. Let's simplify at the start. I have x squared in the numerator and x squared in the denominator. So I can cancel both of those out since x squared divided by x squared is 1. Now note that I also have an x to the negative exponent in the denominator. So I'm going to switch that and put it in the numerator. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3y squared times x to the 1, or simply x, divided by 2 times 4 times y. So now I'll have 3 times y to the 2 minus 1, since my y is in the denominator and the exponent associated with that y is 1, and I'm multiplying that by x, and that's going to be divided by 2 times 4, which is 8. So rewriting this, simplifying my y term, I'll have 3 times y to the 1st, since y to the 2 minus 1 is y to the first, but y to the first is simply y, and that will be multiplied by x, and we'll divide that quantity by 8. So 3xy divided by 8 is our solution in number 8. And I'll stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll complete numbers 9 through 16. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and if you didn't do so before number 8, like, subscribe, and share.